Cowabunga!
Greetings, friends. This is Sonic Toast. You know, ever since the Shredder's Revenge Dimensional Shell Shock DLC has dropped, I have been obsessed with the palette swaps. I have just been racking my brain over pinpointing what each palette swap is specifically referencing. So that's what we're gonna do today. We're gonna take a minute here. We'll look at all the characters and figure out what inspired each of their different alternate colors. Toast. So first off, in the video where I pinpointed all the cameos was before the game was out, so I did not know. There's also cameos from Man Ray, also known as Ray Filet, and his fellow mutanimals, Dreadmon and Jaguar. So that's cool that they included all three of them. And with those, now all six of the original Mighty Mutanimals now appear in Shredder's Revenge in one way or another. All right, now let's get into the costumes. Spoiler warning, if you haven't unlocked them all and don't want to see what they are, you should stop watching this video. Sorry, Toast. Anyway, so let's get into it. So let's go ahead and just start with Raphael, because I feel like he's a very good default turtle that kind of sets the standard for these costumes. So let's go ahead and look at the first one. Of course, this is the default one, which is supposed to represent the 1987 cartoon show. And then Palette 2 is an unlockable one representing the original Raphael action figure. We can see that there are no pupils in his eyes. We can see the different color of green for his skin. He has the black belt, and then his weapons are brown. Palette number 3 represents the live action movie Raphael. You can see like the dirty olive skin, and then the brown arm pads and knee pads also, the brown belt and everything. Very cool. Moving on to Palette number 4, this is the 2003 Raphael. You can completely see by the skin tone. It is different from the action figure one because this has a brown belt along with brown knee pads and brown armbands. Moving on, we have the 2012 Raphael. You can tell by the much lighter skin, the brown knee pads, brown armbands again, the colors of the size, and he has pupils. Then we have the Rise of the TMNT Raphael. We can definitely tell because of the head covering and a red belt. And then he has white armbands and white knee pads representing the sports tape that that version of Raphael seems to wear. Palette number 7 is the black outfit that Raphael wore when he was an intergalactic wrestler in the Archie comics. Palette number 8 was a hard one. This Raphael has green glowing skin, green glowing weapons, red armbands, red knee pads, and a red belt. I scoured the Cowabunga collection. I went through every old Ninja Turtle game from all these obscure consoles, everything I could find, trying to find a palette that looked like this, but none of them ever had such glowing skin or glowing green weapons. And then I realized this has to be the glow-in-the-dark Super 7 action figure with glowing green weapons, glowing green skin, and a bright red belt to match the knee pads, armbands, and mask. Palette 9 is black and white, representing the original Mirage comics. However, his mask is still red. We've seen the turtles like this many times before in artwork, in action figures, in video games. So we're kind of used to seeing them black and white, but still have the red mask because they all wore red masks back in the original Mirage comics, of course. Palette 10 cleverly represents the original Konami video games for the NES. And then Palette 11 is the Game Boy palette swap. So that is pretty fun too. Love the video game references there. So now let's go over the standard that Raphael has set. 1. 1987 cartoon. 2. Action figure. 3. Movie. 4. 2003 cartoon. 5. 2012 cartoon. 6. Rise of the TMNT or 2018 cartoon. 7. Archie comic. 8. Miscellaneous reference. 9. Mirage comics. 10. NES and 11. Game Boy. However, we'll soon see that as hard as the developers tried to stick with this, every character seems to deviate a little, or in some cases, a lot. And buckle in because it gets messy. Now, let's move on to the other three turtles. Palette 1, 1987 cartoon. Palette 2, 1988 action figures. Palette 3, live action movies. Palette 4, 2003 cartoon. Palette 5, 2012 cartoon. Palette 6, Rise, the 2018 cartoon. So far, so good. Palette 7, Mikey has the orange face mask, clearly representing his Archie Comics wrestler costume. Donatello has his yellow and red wrestler mask and red belt. However, I think they added a hint of purple into the red coloring, probably to make him seem more Donatello-y. He also has his yellow armbands and knee pads. He's missing his yellow toga, but it is still quite clear that this is Archie Comics Wrestling Donnie. Now we get to the troublemaker, Leonardo. He has a head covering, orange belt, and silver belt buckle, sort of similar to his wrestler outfit. The color of his swords could also be a reference to his armor. However, if you ask me, he looks much more like he did in that horrible live-action TV show, The Next Mutation. But it's in the Archie wrestler slot. If they were intentionally referencing The Next Mutation, this chronologically should be Leo's fourth palette. Please leave your opinion on this in the comments below. Palette 8, we got the Super 7 Glow in the Dark Turtles. Palette 9, Mirage Turtles. But we have a major deviation as these three are wearing their modern colored masks instead of all wearing red. My guess is the developers did this to make it easier to tell them apart during gameplay. Palette 10, NES. Palette 11, Game Boy. Well, I'm really sorry, friends, but I actually have to cut off the video a little early here. I'm actually really sick and need to go get my rest. I'll finish up the rest of the characters later this week, I promise. Just not able to do it right now, and I didn't want to postpone Turtley Tuesday. So, thank you so much for watching. Have a fantastic day, and toast.